the Daily Log with Captain Jay Galloway. Today I'm going to try to see what I can do about finishing up these daily entries to the Star Trek Las Vegas. It's already August 23rd, and basically I feel like if I don't, I'll probably be covering these for a while. So at least I want to try to finish up, you know, what I have pre-written as far as the 5 days that I did. Well, technically six. So I want to start with day three. And basically, I went to the Star Trek Voyager panel pretty early in the day. Beyond that, I was doing a lot of cosplaying for my DS9 uniform that I was wearing, and also for Star Trek Enterprise augments. I actually discovered I quite enjoy being an augment. And apparently, a lot of people rather enjoyed it too, because they're like, hey, can you get back in your augment outfit? We'd like to take some pictures. I'm like, sure. Cosplaying, if you've never tried it, is definitely an interesting experience. I would recommend it. If you're into, like, getting your picture taken and kind of feeling, I guess, like a little mini star for, like, 5 minutes. Get your 5 minutes of fame. Beyond that, I tried cosplaying, you know, and that was a lot of fun. And I did that all the way up to, basically, it was time to do the Christy Alley panel. And it was a lot of fun watching her live and listening to her. Been a fan of hers for a while now, and I kind of liked her on her reality show, but I really preferred her in Star Trek, Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan. I also liked her on Cheers, and believe it or not, I actually liked her in Look Who's Talking 1 and 2. Of course, I was a kid growing up back in those days, and it was kind of nice having her play that role. But basically, beyond that, Friday went pretty well. It was just a lot, like I said, a lot of cosplaying. I spent a lot of time at Quark's. I definitely got to explore around there, had lunch in there, went into the vendor's floor, got to hang out with a lot of my friends. Also went to, let's see, Priority One, the G&T show, Star Trek Online booth. You know, overall, it was a lot of fun, and got to finish off the night by listening to Rod Roddenberry toast to fans. It went pretty smoothly for the most part. There was a little bit of an issue trying to get the champagne passed around to do the toast, but it all got accomplished in the end, and it was a really nice toast, and I'm really grateful to Rod for doing that, and I believe there's some videos of it, and I might still have, I think I have mine. If I do, I'll attach it to the end of this with any other relevant videos, but beyond that, the whole day went great. Then that night, we went to the, well, myself and Mike went to the Klingon karaoke. My mother kind of just retired for the night. I think she did a little gambling. So she retired for the night and did her own thing. It was a lot of fun, and we really enjoyed day three. So day four came up, which was Saturday. That, like I was telling you earlier about cosplaying, that's the day where you definitely felt like you were a star for, like, you know, your 5 minutes of fame. Basically, everybody got together, dressed up at 8 o'clock in the morning, all got up, we lined up, and then a lot of people were taking our pictures, a lot of people were cheering us, you know. It was a lot of fun. And then they took us all around. We started just outside the vendor's room, went into the vendor's room, went to the different areas, and then ended up on the main stage. Got to walk up on the main stage, which was a lot of fun. I never got to do that before. And then lots and lots of people took pictures of us. It was an amazing experience. If you haven't done that before, I would definitely recommend it. Just realize you're going to be up there for a little while. Beyond that, I went to the 50 years... I went to the 50 Years in Feminism panel that also starred Kate Mulgrew. That was an interesting panel. Definitely didn't really understand what feminism was before, but definitely do now. So I guess in some ways, I guess I am also a feminist. I mean, I believe that women should be treated equally with all rights and respect. I mean, it's really a no-brainer. I don't know why we have such a hard time as a society with that. I also went later that day to go see the TNG panel with Michael Dorn, Jonathan Franks, and Marina Sirtis. It was funny how Jonathan Franks stole the show, basically, and how Marina reacted to it. I mean, those guys just have awesome chemistry. It was great to see them. I also went to the Walter Koenig, I hope I pronounced his last name correctly, I always get that messed up, panel. That was really fun to listen to him. I learned something kind of interesting. I don't know if it's a true tidbit or not. I mean, I'm pretty sure it is because Walter said it himself. But basically, when they were talking about Star Trek Generations, originally, I guess, in the original write-up, the daughter of the on the helmsman of the Enterprise B, which is Hikaru's daughter, was actually supposed to be Chekov's daughter. But I guess last minute they kind of changed that. Not exactly sure why, but that's kind of a cool little piece of tidbit. Then I went to the Priority One Podcast Presents Stand By Me, Don't Hail Me. In order to do so, I actually had to miss out on the Captain... Well, William Shatner, a.k.a. Captain Kirk, and also Scott Bakula, a.k.a. Captain Archer panels in order to do that. So, a little love to my friends over at Priority One. You know, hey guys, I missed out on watching two good panels to check you guys out, and it was kind of awesome. I was a little late, so I didn't get to partake in your game, but, you know, I did get a couple cool posters after the fact. So, thank you guys for that. And, that also went, after that, I went over to the Kate Mulgrew panel and got to listen to her. And that was an interesting experience. Got to listen to her being in Ireland for the past year and about her new house and everything she's gone through. The Saturday night, my mom and I decided we were going to take the night off of partying. So we actually went to the Star Trek Las Vegas trip. And we enjoyed the night. We started, basically, we went for my wife's grandma. I ended up going over to the Coca-Cola store. We went over to M&M World. I mean, we did all those things, picked up a couple little souvenirs, and then a couple more dresses for my daughter and my wife. And we then turned around and went all the way over to Caesar's Palace. It's really not as far as it sounds, but it is a couple miles, so. We went over to Caesar's Palace, and I'll try to post those videos in here as well at the end of this. But it was a lot of fun. And we went and saw the Fall of Atlantis show, and then we headed back to the hotel that night. Day 5, basically. Well, I think I'll cover day 5 in my next vlog. I'm already getting up to like 6 minutes, and plus I got a couple of videos I want to post, so without further ado, here are those videos. Don't mess with these guys. Hang on. Thank you. watching my vlog through today. This is Captain Jay Galloway signing off.